Seth Rollins, aka Seth Freakin' Rollins, doesn't think that The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, could lace his boots during The Rock's best days, let alone now. But the only problem with that is, Seth, it doesn't matter what you think. Welcome back, guys, to Fog Wrestling. And Seth Freakin' Rollins has came out and said not only is he better than The Rock, but The Rock could not even lace his boots. But what boots exactly is Seth Rollins talking about? Is he talking about wrestling boots? Is he talking about the big clown boots that he often wears on Monday Night Raw? Or is he talking about his wife Becky Lynch's high heels that he probably wears at home, since he's constantly dressing in women's clothing? This guy is an absolute goof. So Seth, take your wrestling boots, take your clown boots, take your high heels, turn all those shoes sideways and stick them straight up your candy ass. Seth Rollins doing an interview with Submission Radio, and he said the following about The Rock. He says, quote, "Yeah, I mean, look, he's rattled, man, he's rattled, he's shook. He came in here thinking he's going to do whatever he wanted to do, so now he's trying to throw his weight around and he's got all the same insults that he's had for the last 20 years. It's kind of sad in some ways, but he wants to run his mouth. Dude, he's going to get whooped. I mean, he's a specimen, but the dude's out of practice. He hasn't wrestled in 10 years. I mean, I'm the world heavyweight champion for a reason. He couldn't lace my boots in his best days, let alone now. So he can run his mouth all he wants when he wants to show up. I dare him to put his hands on me, because if he slapped me the way he slapped Cody, if nobody was there to hold me back, oh baby, I'd be clawing the eyes out of his head. Rey Mysterio, poof, eat your heart out. You know what I mean. You got The Rock and he's talking his smack. You got Roman Reigns, Cody Rhodes. I mean, we're in the middle of one of the greatest runs in the history of our industry, and I am psyched to be dead smack in the middle of it." End of quote, man. There's so much funny shit here to take out of this. I mean, first of all, for him to say he's better than The Rock, that is just asinine. What a fucking ridiculous statement there from Seth freaking Rollins. But he talks about how The Rock is running his mouth, and how The Rock, if he slapped if he slapped Seth the way he slapped Cody, Seth Rollins would whoop him. The same Seth Rollins that when a crowd jumped the barricade, the guy just cowered. He rolled up in a ball. He took the defensive position. It's almost like he rolled up and showed his ass to this guy in front of the crowd, hoping that some would get stuck in it, something big probably. But yeah, this guy was terrified when some loser from the crowd jumped him. So what chance would he have of beating up The Rock? I tell you what chance he would have. In the words of Vincent Kennedy McMahon, he would have no chance in hell. And then he talks about The Rock talking smack. He talks about Roman Reigns and Cody Rhodes, and he says that we're in the middle of one of the greatest runs in our history. But he claims to be better than The Rock. Okay, fair enough. Why is Seth Rollins so desperately trying to insert himself in a feud and a storyline that doesn't bother him? If he's better than The Rock, why doesn't he do his own thing? Why doesn't he make his title and his feud with Drew McIntyre on Raw? Why doesn't he make that this huge thing, this huge deal, going into WrestleMania? If the guy's so relevant, if the guy's so much better than The Rock, why is he so desperate to be Cody's number two, to be Cody's backup in Cody's feud and rivalry with the Bloodline? If Seth Rollins is that great, shouldn't he be focusing on the world title? Shouldn't he be focusing on his number one contender, Drew McIntyre? But he's not. You know, the guy doesn't want to be on Raw. The guy wants to push his way in to this Bloodline feud because he knows that working with The Rock is better for him. He doesn't want to work with Drew McIntyre. He can't bring the eyes to the product. Nobody cares about Seth Rollins like they care about The Rock. But if they did, then The Rock would be chasing Seth Rollins. It wouldn't be Seth Rollins desperately trying to get involved with The Rock and whatever The Rock's doing on SmackDown and the Bloodline shit. I think it's actually embarrassing. We've got Seth Rollins turning up at Elimination Chamber, sitting beside Cody Rhodes, holding Cody Rhodes' hand. Meanwhile, he's got an Elimination Chamber match deciding his opponent, and he doesn't even care about it. He doesn't even talk about it. He doesn't even focus on it. The guy wants nothing to do with anything on Raw. It's because he's not important. He's not a real world champion. That belt's a prop. It doesn't matter. That what matters is what's happening with The Rock. Whatever show The Rock's on, whatever main event The Rock's involved in, that is the main event. That's the only main event. Seth Rollins knows that, and that's why he's so desperate to get involved. That's why he's so desperate to be part of that story, and that's why he's calling out The Rock. But incredibly foolish here for Seth to say that he was better than The Rock and that The Rock couldn't lace his boots. What, just because Seth Rollins does moves off the top rope and The Rock didn't? I mean, fucking bullshit. The Rock will go down as one of the greatest of all time. I mean, The Rock would be in most people's top four. You look at the people's Mount Rushmore, most people will have The Rock, and that's like, not just fans, but I'm talking people from the wrestling industry, people that have been in wrestling for like years, decades. Who has Seth Rollins as their number one guy, or in their top four, or even in their top 10? Nobody. It's just a guy that has been around during the worst era of wrestling, and he's been handed a top role in the company because there's nobody else. He's in the era of wrestling where they don't want to create stars. They want WWE to be the selling point. WWE is the star, and everyone else just works in the company. But you can tell this guy, man. Look at with CM Punk. He threatened to beat up CM Punk even though he can't fight for shit. He's threatening to beat up The Rock now, even though he can't fight for shit. He's calling it guys that are way more over, way more successful, way more popular than he will ever be. And it's desperation from Seth Rollins. And I think Roman Reigns even said it. I believe it was Roman Reigns when he says, "You're not even the man in your own household." And that's true. That is, it might not have been Roman Reigns. I might be giving Roman Reigns credit for something he didn't say. But that's legit. I mean, Becky Lynch is a bigger star than Seth Rollins. You look at the way she got pushed from, 2019 onwards. She's done more than Seth Rollins has. I mean, I don't even recall Seth Rollins main eventing a WrestleMania because he was the A-side. I don't think he's ever main evented a WrestleMania where he was the A-side. I know he cashed in, then there may have been a 1 year where he main evented, but other than that, he's just a B-plus player. He's just a guy that tags along, and now he's trying to tag along with The Rock, because The Rock's great. The Rock is the great one, the Brahma Bull. And Seth Rollins, like I said, he's just someone that's been lucky enough to be inserted as a main eventer during a time where wrestling absolutely sucks. So here, Seth Rollins, enjoy the rub, stick close to The Rock, try and gain as much popularity and eyeballs as you can while you're with The Rock. The Rock will maybe lead you to some success, but to claim you're better than The Rock and that you could actually whoop The Rock's ass, look at the size of The Rock, holy fuck. I mean, The Rock could probably just snap Seth Rollins with his eyebrow. The Rock could probably lift Seth Rollins on his eyebrow. He could, instead of lifting weights, The Rock could just plant Seth Rollins on top of his eyebrow, probably go to the gym and push out 50 reps. Anyway, guys, that's it. Catch you in the next one. Let me know your thoughts down below. And until next time, peace.